today we are with Mr. Uday Vaskar, a known foreign policy expert of India. So, Mr. Vaskar, I mean, I know that being a naval officer, you have spent quite a good amount of time in the place of action. So, how did your heart go when you were seeing everything that with which you are probably too familiar with?
The events of Bombay over the last 3 days have clearly been very agonizing for everybody in India. The scale of this attack and the sheer audacity with which it had been conducted in a way exposes or reveals the vulnerability of democracies like India, large metropolitan cities like Mumbai, and the way in which they have now become victims of this global trend of terrorism, which has a very, very virulent regional dimension about it. Many lessons will be learnt now that this operation has been successfully concluded, and many of the systemic inadequacies as far as India's own management of internal security are concerned will come up for very, very detailed review, and hopefully the appropriate degree of redressal will also be initiated in the shortest time.
But Mr. Bhaskar, do you think that Indian people at this point are in a state of belief to believe that the Indian government at all can come up with a counter-terrorism policy? Because we have seen 10 major terrorist attacks from May to November, and not only that, in 1993 it is through the same sea route that all the RDX was imported in. Until then, we have not taken any kind of precaution or change in our procedures. So, do you think that the Indian people are in a mood to believe that we can do any better in terms of security?
Well, clearly the Indian people are very angry just now. They are very anguished. And because the entire Bombay tragedy unfolded in real time on television throughout the length and breadth of this country, the current emotional state of the country is perhaps predictable. But as a security analyst, I would like to submit that this is also a time for us to have a little more objective reflection about what has happened and what needs to be done. Yes, I think the Indian state must be held responsible, because in many ways it has failed in its primary duty of providing security to the citizens. But the nature of the challenge or the nature of the adversary and the complexity of dealing with this should also be placed in context. Personally, I can think of many things that the Indian state could have done better. I can think of many areas where the political leadership of this country and the top bureaucracy have been found wanting. But all the more reason why there should be an objective reflection to find out how we need to improve existing security procedures. So the faith in the system must not be completely given up, because this is the only system we have. Anyone who suggests that the current democratic dispensation of India either cannot deal with this or needs to be changed, I would consider that to be perhaps a very, very invalid conclusion to draw from what has happened.
No, I agree with you. I agree with you. The only democracy perfects a democracy. There is nothing called pure and perfect democracy. But the question is, because a democracy perfects a democracy, I mean, I'm an ordinary citizen and you are a security expert. So tell me, I mean, you have been in the security circle all over the Delhi, and you know it better than me. So tell me why. I mean, I'm pretty sure the security expert knew what will be telling me what is need to be implemented. Then why they didn't implement those things? I mean, was there any political pressure? What held them back?
Biplab, now that you asked this question, let me say that 10 years ago in India, in Delhi, a very detailed recommendation had been made after the 1999 Kargil war, in which one of the areas that had been identified was border management, the management of border security. And the vulnerability of India to the maritime routes was highlighted. Various recommendations were made. And this is in many ways a sad reflection that for 10 years our system was not able to implement many of the recommendations that had been made, which I think in a non-linear way has led to the tragedy of Mumbai. My own assessment is that this has happened because of a certain degree of political indifference, as also the way in which security itself has been approached by the elite of this country. For the last 10 years, while India has been facing terrorism in a consistent manner, all attempts at improving security have by and large led to an improvement in what I would call as VIP security, or the security of the elites. Consequently, public security, as we understand it in a normative sense, has not received the kind of attention it needs. And I still place the blame squarely with the ruling dispensation, the politician, as also the senior bureaucracy, which in many ways, I think, is guilty of a certain degree of indifference and disdain for what should have been a primary responsibility. These are the areas that Indian democracy should really be looking at. Personally, for the last 3 days, I've been suggesting that this country needs to convene an immediate special session of parliament where for 3-4 days, whatever length of time it takes, internal security and its various dimensions need to be discussed so that we are able to arrive at a consensus in Indian parliament about what steps need to be taken. I've said it with Bombay, this country is at war. A war has been waged against India and Bombay in particular.
So, Mr. Bhaskar, as a naval officer, you are very familiar with the maritime threat or the security threat from that part of western part of India that we are facing right now. So, can you tell me your own assessment of threat, if that is not, you know, too secretive?
Well, clearly, we have a very complex maritime security challenge in India. This is something that had been noted, as I said, many years ago post-Kargil, saying that on one hand, India has a very distinctive position in Southern Asia, both geographically and ideologically, and it was only a matter of time before the forces that are ranged against India decided to take the sea route. And Bombay specifically, if you look at its topography, is a very open harbor. And now with the construction of New Bombay, Navi Mumbai as it's called, has increased the ingress as far as the city itself is concerned. And after 9/11 and what happened in New York, many security experts in the world had assessed the possibility of terrorism taking the maritime route. So to that extent, various studies had been carried out. It's just that the actual security of a city like Mumbai has not been adequately managed in terms of the responsibilities of different organizations. As of now, maritime security in India has been given to 3 different agencies, which is the Indian Navy as the lead service, the lead armed forces service of India, the Indian Coast Guard, which is also an armed force but which has a different mandate, and the Indian Customs, who have their own responsibility as far as ports are concerned. There has been talk about creating maritime police with individual states, particularly the maritime states of India, but this has not been implemented in a serious or effective manner. So therefore, we have the kind of situation where in the current incident that we are talking about, the terrorists were able to come as close to the gateway of India in small rafts and boats and unload whatever material they did. I mean, this is the reconstruction of the event. So there is a case for much greater coordination of the maritime security of major ports like Mumbai. And this is what I mean when I said that many lessons have to be learned from the tragedy of Mumbai on November 26th.
But even if, when I agree that we don't know when terrorists will strike, but even when the terror struck in Mumbai, why, even if, you know, I have full respect for all the ATS officers who have given their life for the country, why they didn't went through without first accessing the information and assessing the situation on ground? Clearly, the ATS in Maharashtra didn't assess the first initial set of information properly before they started charging, and as a result, NSG was brought in late. I mean, why do you think this mistake has happened?
Again, Biplab, I think the reason is that in hindsight, you know, many things become much, much clearer. But when an incident is unfolding, and we had the kind of density of events that we did in the first few